Bilingual extraction with SketchEngine's one-click terms works two different ways. It can either work with texts that are already aligned, like a translation memory, and you can see the various formats there, or it can work with non-aligned documents when one of them is a translation of the other. There's just one new step that goes on behind the scenes, which is aligning the two documents. We go to one-click terms, click start here. The middle one, two languages, would be if we had a TM. But the one on the right, two languages, non-aligned documents, is what we click on. We'll pick our two languages. In this case, I recommend that the language you're working into be the one that you put on the left. That's my personal preference. And then you pick the documents in each of the languages. It takes a tiny bit of time, but this is what you end up with after that process. So you can see before we had single and multi-word terms just for one language, for English. And now we also have single and multi-word terms for the other language we picked. And the most exciting feature, as far as I'm concerned, is this bilingual terms feature. Basically, what the machine is doing is it's looking at these two documents, it's trying to align them, and then it's identifying a term in the first language, and it's identifying a potential equivalent of that term in the other language. Then it allows us to go through, and you can see there are various options right here, right? Biodiversity loss could be pérdida de biodiversidad, but there are also a few other options that it comes up with here. And I can just pick the one that is the right option, biodiversity, biodiversidad. What happens is that it automatically selects all of the terms. And I like to deselect all. And then I know that I personally have gone through and approved the terms that I'm going to download or export or use in some way. Okay, nature restoration is kind of interesting here because you can see that, for those of you who speak Spanish, that it's given me a couple options, some of which are longer than others. Restoration of ecosystems in water and in freshwater. So let's say that the term is actually recuperación de ecosistemas without the last two words. I can simply click on the little pencil here to edit the term, hit enter, and you can see it's now been revised to download and work with later. Let's click on the parallel concordancer. And what was the term? Invasive alien species. All right, so first of all, I'm going to correct it in English, because it's going to have that S in English. Again, we've got that little pencil to make a correction on either side. And then I can go here. It's basically showing me how it has aligned or tried to align these two texts. And then I could simply search for invasive alien species to see what it is. And up here it is in Spanish, especies exóticas invasoras. And I could copy that. And then go over here, especies exóticas. So if there's something where I don't see a translation that looks right coming up, I just use that parallel concordancer, look for it over here, and I can find it. After I've gone through and identified my terms, I click on download, and I pick the format that I want. So if I'm going to be putting it into my cat tool, I probably want TBX. Otherwise, if I'm going to be putting this into some sort of a tool for interpreters, I usually pick XLSX. I'll click download. To prepare this to go into my tool, I just go into Excel. I delete this frequency information, which I don't need. I change the headers so that my tool will probably recognize them. I hit save, and then that will be ready for me to upload to whatever tool that I'm working with.